In this video, AI runs my Instagram account completely on autopilot, making posts like this, this, and this. Yes, that's right, this may be the first and last post I actually make using my human hands to my Instagram account. The rest of this process is going to be entirely automated with high quality posts. And I do place the emphasis on high quality now that GPT-4o can make images like this. Let's get stuck in. The first thing I'll do is use Airtable to start from scratch with a brand new base. Essentially, it's a fancy spreadsheet that can store all the posts I'm about to make. There we go, create a magic Instagram, give it a nice color, and now we can start to arrange the table. Okay, I've customized the look, now I'm going to edit the first field. This is the most important one, we'll call it post ID, and we'll make sure it's set to auto number, which is down here. Save that, now you'll see you get 1, 2, 3, and we can actually go ahead and sort that by post ID, and we can sort it the other way around, so always the latest creations will be at the top of our table. Now we'll just go ahead and make the rest of the fields. Video ID, quote, post, type with three options, character, quote, and meme. Image field, status with options, pending, approved, and published with traffic light colors. Image link, and finally post link. Okay, that's done. Now we've got our social media dashboard inside Airtable. We can start to integrate this and really make an automated system for publishing to Instagram. So let's go ahead and hook this all up. Here I am inside Zapier, and I'm going to start from scratch with a brand new Zap. Now for the trigger, we're going to use YouTube, and the trigger event will be every time there is a new video. This polls my account every 2 minutes, so every time there's a video published, this instantly triggers. And the first step is now complete. Every time a new video appears on my channel, my researcher starts to create post ideas for Instagram. The next step will also be YouTube, and this is where we want to grab the captions or the transcript of the video. So I'm going to ask for here an API request, and we'll make sure we're connected to the Creator Magic channel. This is important because you can only pull transcripts from your own content and not other content on YouTube with this method. Okay, setting this up is pretty simple. Let's make it big so we can see what we're doing here. So we are not stopping on errors. We're getting, and we're getting it from this URL here. Now for query string parameters, we need to do part, and that is a snippet. And then we add another value here, and this is going to be video ID. And then we add the video ID, and this comes from the first step. It is, of course, the ID provided from the new video part of the Zap. And then look down here. Yes, we get back a load of JSON data. Now, don't worry about it because we'll make sense of this so we can get that transcript. For the next step, I will add in code here. And this is really simple. We're going to execute a bit of JavaScript to get what we need. And we'll replace this with this JavaScript here. Now, don't worry. I'll link to the template and everything you need to be able to do this so you can set it up for yourself. It'll be down in the description below. We've also got to put as the input data up here, captions. And for the field here, we're going to look at the API request and put in the response body. With that all done, we should be able to test the step, and indeed we get a caption ID back so we can obtain the transcript. Next step is from YouTube again, and we're doing an API request. Similar setup as before, the URL is the same captions API endpoint, and then we'll add in the ID that our code step obtained. Only one thing needed here for the query string parameters, that's TFMT, and it's just the type of transcript we want. SRT is usually pretty YouTube friendly. And we'll test the step. And boom, as we scroll down, have a look at this. Yes, this is indeed a transcript from one of my recent YouTube videos, all extracted inside my Zapier Zap. This is really exciting. Now we can create really shareable stuff for Instagram using AI. Now it's super easy. New video on Creator Magic, find transcript ID, get transcript ID, download transcript. Let's move on to the next step. Now that we've got the transcript, we've got superpowers. And of course, we're going to call OpenAI into the mix to do some serious stuff with this transcript. As the action event, we're going to have a conversation. Now, in the user message, this is where we do some serious prompt engineering. So, here I've said extract the 5 most meaningful quotes from below and give a JSON object containing the text and also the category. So, are we going to have a character, a quote, or a meme post on Instagram? This is the kind of format I want to see back. Do not include explanations or notes, only the JSON array. And then the transcript is what we'll put into this wonderful chat here. And we can call that by going /, looking down here at download transcript, and clicking the response body. So now we've got the full prompt along with the transcript at the bottom. Now, it's very important you can choose your model. And for testing, I think I will go with GPT-4o Mini. But when I run this in production, I'm actually going to switch it up to ChatGPT-03 for the most powerful reasoning to find the very best quotes to use on my Instagram. That's easily done by searching for a model here, and I could select 03. Nothing else really needs to be changed here, but I am going to change the temperature to 0.3 just to make this output a little more accurate and reliable each time. Let's continue and let's go ahead and test. Okay, you'll see we've got a response and we've got five ideas here that have all been categorized into categories. This is really cool stuff. Now we can move on. And for the next step, we're using code. Input data will be raw text, and we're going to bring from those powerful quotes the reply text. Once we've done that, I'll paste in that code, which of course will be linked up down below in my notes. Let's test the step to see what happens. And boom, now you'll see we've got an array of quotes here, the quote text and category, all neatly laid out there. This is great because it means we can get our Zap to loop through those five quotes and get them into Airtable. And now for the next step, we will bring in looping from Zapier so we can loop over those five quotes. Action event will be loop from line items. We need two values to loop. First is the quote. That's our quote text. And for the second value, we're looking for the category. And again, we'll map that back to our latest code step. And now we're going to loop over all the quotes that were pulled in. And let's quickly test. Yes, you can see it's looping over and it's finding those quotes 3, 4, 5 different times. Inside the loop, we'll add a step, and this will be OpenAI again. Conversation. Now again, this is where prompt engineering comes in. I'm asking it to write an Instagram caption, 125 characters or less, and it should feel natural, likable, clearly reference the latest YouTube video, not include hashtags, they're very old-fashioned, and no quotation marks or extra narration, concise, punchy, and under 125 characters so it doesn't get truncated. Up here, we'll use a forward slash and we'll insert the quote that's come through from our first loop iteration. This is the final bit of our researcher. Now we're going to add the step to connect to our Airtable with Zapier, and there it is. If you never connected Airtable at all, remember to sign in, and we'll choose here to create a record. Choose the correct base, which will be Creator Magic Instagram, and the table, which will be posts. Post ID we'll leave blank because that's auto-increasing. Video ID we'll pull in from our new video on Creator Magic. Quote, that's going to come in from our loop here. The post will be the response from our AI inside the loop, which is right here. Category will be from inside the loop. In this case, it's character. Image we'll leave blank because we haven't generated that yet. And then status we can choose. If you're cautious and want to approve things before they go live, make it pending. But I want this to be fully autonomous, so I'll have it auto approve. Let's continue and let's test this step. And boom, it seems to be done. Let's go back to Airtable. And we can see here we've got a video ID with a quote, a post, a type, no image yet, status is approved, and indeed the date that it was added. Let's publish this app. And now we'll create a new app and we'll rename it. This is the Instagram creator, and the trigger will come from Airtable. Every time there's a new or updated record inside our Instagram base, posts table. Now here it's asking for a last modified column, which we don't have. So we can simply add the last modified time to our base here. Now we'll go back, refresh the results, and we've got a last modified column. Continue, test, and boom, look at that. Record C is indeed the record we just inserted with our Instagram researcher. I'm going to add in paths here. This will split into one of three paths, depending on whether it's a character, a quote, or a meme post that we're putting out on Instagram. Okay, because we've got three different categories, it can go one of three ways. And we just add in the conditions, and we'll say if type exactly matches character, continue. And of course, the path would continue on this particular post type. We'll do the same for the others. Now, next up, I hand off to Amazon's Lambda service to use GPT-4o image generation. Presently, Zapier doesn't have this natively. Hopefully in the future they will do, but it also takes a little time, sometimes upwards of a minute or more, to generate the image. So the image will be generated and then handed back to a webhook at Zapier to continue. For this, I'll create a function, call it Instagram creator, and simply create the function. Okay, that Instagram creator function is created. To make it work, I just upload the zip file, which I'll link to down below for you to use as well. With that done, I'll create an Amazon S3 bucket to store my images. I think CM Instagram images will be good. So we'll go ahead and create that bucket. Now we'll edit the configuration for this so it works perfectly. First, we'll configure the timeout to be 3 minutes, as it sometimes takes a while to make those images. Under permissions, We want to go ahead and create an inline policy in JSON format and allow the ability to access CM Instagram images on Amazon S3. Finally, under environment variables, we'll edit and add a few here, like the S3 bucket name, our OpenAI key, and the Zapier webhook URL that we'll create in our next zap. Before we go ahead and do anything else, I'd suggest we click test and actually test this out. We need to provide three keys, a record ID, a type, and a quote. I might also go ahead and add on a reference image from my YouTube video. Okay, before we do anything else, I'm testing with a dummy record ID, type of character, quote, and the image that I want to use too. Let's test. And this is really cool. It seems to have worked. It's provided me with an S3 URL. Let's open it. And hey, that's not bad, is it? For a first Instagram post, I really quite like that. That's really cool. We'll test that again. Boom, not too bad. Very quotable, very clickable, very Instagram friendly. And finally, as we're on a roll, let's check the meme function works by testing. Boom. Now that is very meme-like. I like it. I'm not quite sure that's me, but it's a meme. What do you expect? So with this very clever Lambda function working, we'll just insert it as the option for each of our paths in the Instagram creator. So we search for AWS Lambda here. And for this, we need to invoke a function async. Under configure, choose your region and the function name. Arguments are important. This is what we'll send through to be created. Now, remember, we need a record ID. This will come in from Airtable, and you see it's included here. Then we need a type, and for accuracy, of course, we can bring this in from Airtable, and there it is. We're going to need a quote to work with. Again, Airtable has that. And for this character post, of course, we're going to add in a beautiful image to work with. Now, what is interesting, every time you upload a video, YouTube actually clips out three highlights from your videos that you can use. And those highlights are located at img.youtube.com/vi/yourvideoid and then 1.jpg. There I am. It's rather small, but as you can see, GPT-4o can make something from that. Can also change that to 2 and 3. So we'll put in a holding URL here. But before I execute that, let's use a random number between 1 and 3 to decide which clip of the video we're going to use for this beautiful generation. Let's add formatter in just before. We're working with numbers, and we want a random number between 1 and 3 to 0 decimal points. This is an easy test. Boom, formatter chose 1. We can retest, and this time we got 2. There we go. Now everything looks like it makes sense and we're good. So we can publish this Instagram creator. Now we want to go ahead and create another zap. There's a lot of zaps here. We'll call this one Instagram Listener. We start this one off with a webhook and we want to catch the hook. This will get triggered the instant our GPT-4o image creator is complete. Most important thing is to copy that webhook and paste it into Zapier webhook URL here in your Lambda environment variables. With that done, I'm running a quick test event to make sure it works. And when it's complete, we'll get that URL returned. But most importantly over here in Zapier, when we test, we've got a new record here and it's got the quote, the type, the image URL from Amazon S3 as well. So we'll continue. And this one's really simple because we just need to insert the data into Airtable, create or update record. Now here it says to update a record, which is what we'll be doing, we need to use a lookup field. So over here in our Airtable, we're going to add in a formula field right here, and this will pull in the record ID. And if I start typing record ID, there it is. And boom, now all of our rows have record IDs added. Now we can refresh and we can see the record ID field is there. Now we go on, we don't need to update anything apart from the image here, which will come in from what we got from the webhook, which is the image URL. And we'll also use that here for the image link. And again, that's coming exactly the same from the webhook right there. Continue and we'll test the step. And now have a look at that. Not only can you see there is an image here that we can enlarge and see right here inside our Airtable, but we've actually got the direct link to Amazon S3 if we want to click it and see it in real size. So this is all working incredibly well. The last step is to set up a publish step. Call it Instagram Publisher and we'll work on a schedule. Let's select every day at midnight, not triggering at weekends. We then use formatter to get numbers, a random number between 0 and 720, that's a 12-hour range. We'll then delay this zap for that random amount of minutes. This way, we allow Zapier to publish to our Instagram at random times every day. And then we'll go to Airtable, find a record. We'll be searching by status approved. And of course, if there are no posts, we'll mark it as safely halted and skip the rest of the steps here. And indeed, it's found the record here, the latest one with all the details on the image we need to publish to Instagram. So finally, we can add the Instagram step in and be completely finished. We'll choose Creator Magic. We can pull this in from Airtable. There's the image link. The caption, again, will be inside Airtable. And in the future, we can choose to tag users and add a location if we like. Finally, with everything here ready to go into Instagram, let's test the step and see if we can automate Instagram. Yes, it worked, and hey, look at this. I've just posted to my Instagram using that automation I have set up. How cool is that? I can't wait to see what you do with Zapier, automating your Instagram account with AI, repurposing content you've already made on YouTube, but you could also use it for podcasts, blogs, whatever you're creating online. Let me know how you'll be using it in the comments down below. And also head over to my community. It's also linked up, and all the resources and tools you'll need to get this set up will be right over there. Good luck with this. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now. You should watch next. Thanks.